Well, hello everybody, welcome back to another video on the Minecraft with a Y server. I am Adaram, and there have been quite a few changes since my last two episodes. I know I talked a lot about the inactivity on the server at the moment, and as of recently, Eagle's been playing on the server a lot, and we've actually been working a little bit on getting spawn towns situated and everything. And most importantly, there's been a rule change on the server. We are no longer playing by the rule that you have to build and collect resources only from one specific biome. We are now basically back to regular survival Minecraft. There are no more limitations on what kind of farms you can build. And, of course, fairly important to me, of course, is that there is no more limitation on strip mining. So I am now allowed to build a massive strip mine, which I have made a bit of a reputation for among the people who I have played on servers with in the past. So, actually, I've done a little bit of work down here in the storage room. I actually started working on this before the whole rule change happened, and I was planning on making an episode on it. And then I decided I wanted to make an episode that involved talking about some of the things that changed and what else I've been working on over at Spawn. So I got my little enchanting setup. I actually just recently, right before we went back to regular survival Minecraft, I got the full enchantment setup. So that's cool. That's set up. I have anvil and everything, and I've actually been enchanting quite a bit. I have a fairly decent helmet. I've got fairly decent boots. These are okay. My chest plate's actually really good too. Although I don't really like thorns that much because it tends to break a lot quicker because you use it up a lot faster when your enemies end up hitting you. I do have a really good pickaxe now. Sword, I think I added sharpness to that since the last time. My bow's a little bit better too, although I'm running out of arrows. Gotta fix that at some point. And yeah, and I also set up a little brewing station over here, and I also have a couple of mini nether wart farms. In these chests are water bottles, and then I have an infinite water supply so I can fill up my water bottles there. Although I can fill up my water bottles in the fountain over here, but I did want to have an infinite water supply in case I need that for anything else. So I also set up an ender chest, and as you can see, I have quite a few diamonds already, although 13 isn't really that many. A couple other picks and such. I do have a fortune pick, although it's on an iron pick, and it does not have efficiency, but that has been really helpful in, because I've only found one vein of diamonds so far. But yeah, I did a little bit of strip mining. I'm planning on doing a lot more now that that option is now available. I don't think I have any other reason to be down here that I could think of. So I guess we're heading back upstairs, and I want to show off what's been going on at Spawn, assuming there's nothing else I need to show off in my house. I don't think there was. We're definitely taking a little bit of a break from the house over here. I know I've only done, what, like 4 episodes over here, one of which was another trip, so that doesn't really count. But, I mean, I'm definitely going to pop back here and do work on here every so often. But I think my main focus, now that have removed all the restrictions and everything, is going to be working on Spawn. I know Eagle has a lot of plans for working on Spawn as well, and I think he's starting on some stuff. He's the one who built the fountain over in the center of Spawn. I actually just recently also set up a portal system, so of course my portal's back there. There actually was a little hallway down here that leads to Daikon's portal. That was the only nether portal in the world before, and it was actually the one that my portal connected to before I got the portals properly set up. So yeah, it's not too long a trip, that's why I'm not really cutting it out. If it was a bit longer, and in the future I'll probably cut it out. And at some point we probably are going to want to work on a nether hub, but I feel like since there aren't that many players playing at the moment, we may want to focus on getting Spawn Town done. There's also mention of adding some more members to the server, which I think would be great, because a lot of our members have expressed some disinterest in playing Minecraft at the moment, just being generally bored with it and all that stuff. And I think it'd be great if we could pull a couple more members onto the server. Of course, I have no idea who we would want to bring onto the server, because I don't really know a lot of people outside of maybe like some ex-Farside members, but I feel like most of them have either disappeared or already connected elsewhere. That I know of, the only members who are still posting content are Tortimer, who is obviously on Timeshot server, and Sneaksnag, who I don't think is on a SMP server, but he's more of a PvP, UHC kind of guy. I don't know if he really, because he never really played that much on the server, though. I don't know, he played occasionally. Mostly he just sat in the chat and complained about Optifine not being updated. Alright, so here's our fountain. I haven't actually shown off Spawn in my videos yet, because there really isn't much here yet. But it looks like Eagle's been working on a path over here. It looks like we'll be going with andesite. I think this is the andesite. And blah. What are these called? Stone slabs. Stone slabs. That's what those are. So it looks like that's gonna be our pass system. So this is of course center spawn. I'm actually gonna be working on the portal shelter, if you could call that, like a little, just a little hut to house the portal. I mean, it's gonna be open air. It's kind of like if you remember Farsight Season 2, my ice biome lodge place that had the little portal structure in there. That's basically what I'm gonna be building over there. And of course, you're probably wondering what this building over here is, the first real building other than the fountain over at spawn. And this is my chicken shack. I named it What the Cluck because I thought it was kind of funny. Obviously, there's a little chicken on top. And inside is an auto chicken cooker. This is actually the first time I've ever built one of these. And I really wanted to make some kind of source of food at spawn, especially since we're talking about adding some new members on. I think it'd be great if new members had somewhere to go get some food. And yeah, so it hasn't built up that much yet, but I do have a lot of chickens up there. I don't know if you can tell how many are up there, but there are a lot, trust me on that. And I mean, basically how it works is I throw a bunch of chickens and I stick them up there. They lay eggs onto a couple hoppers. The hoppers lead down to a dispenser, which spits out the eggs right here. The baby chickens, when they grow up into the lava, burns to death, and create cooked chicken down here. And of course, there's also some feathers. I might make a sorting system to get those feathers out of there, but I might leave them in there. I don't know. We'll see. It hasn't really started overflowing just yet, but obviously there are a lot more feathers than chicken, which of course is something that would be useful for new members to get if they're planning on getting some bows and arrows set up. So I have it set up like a restaurant. Of course, the chicken itself is actually free. I put a sign up here, mostly for new members, but if you need food at all and you're by spawn, then you can go ahead and stop by here and grab some. There's a sign that also says don't be greedy because I don't want somebody taking all of it and leaving nothing behind. Of course, we have some sides. This is supposed to be like the counter you would order at. I'm planning on putting a couple of, what are the words? The things you put the items in. The item frames, that's what they're called. I'm planning on putting a couple of those in there with, like, a chicken inside it or something like that. And that way it looks kind of like a menu. And, of course, this is where you form the line and all that, you know? Just like a fast food place. I'm planning on putting something back here as, like, a register, but I haven't figured out exactly what to use for that just yet. Possibly, like, stone brick stairs, maybe? But I feel like that would make it hard, because you wouldn't be able to see over it. I feel like I gotta make something smaller than that. I'm not sure what, though. I gotta figure that out yet. So that's What the Cluck, the chicken restaurant on the server. So what I'm gonna be focusing on, and I'm not doing any building this episode, I just wanted to make an update video about what's been going on the server, and, you know, what's happening going forward with, Minecraft with a Y. What I'm going to be doing in the future, in fact, I'm probably going to be doing it after I record this episode, is working on a lot of little buildings around spawn. I want to hold off. I have some really big plans for some really big builds I want to do on the server, but I want to hold off on starting those builds until activity on the server starts to pick up. I mean, I'm really excited now that we can go back to playing survival Minecraft. I can go collect whatever resources I want. I can go into the savannah, collect some savannah wood. I can go into the desert, collect some sand, you know, all of that. So there are some big builds I want to do, but I'm going to hold off until server activity picks up so I can be sure that all my time spent on those kinds of builds is not going to go to waste. So basically what I'm going to be doing is building a whole bunch of small buildings. And these are going to be buildings that are mainly geared towards new players joining the server, because I know hopefully we'll have a couple of those. So right now I have obviously the chicken shop to get some food and some feathers to make arrows. And I'm also going to set up probably like an armor and a weapon shop. And basically in that shop, I'll probably have a lot of the armor that I get from my zombie XP grinder, because I get a lot of armor. Some of it's actually pretty decent, some of it's not so good, but it's great armor to get if you're just starting out and you just like basically just spawn in and don't have anything. It'll get you started, it'll keep you going for a little while. So I was kind of planning on setting up a shop like that. Again, not a shop that you actually have to buy from. It's going to be like the chicken What the Cluck, with basically everything there is going to be free. And basically geared towards newer players or anybody who's at spawn who needs some armor. Again, it's not going to be great armor. It's just going to be whatever I get dropped off the zombies. I've also heard that there's a skeleton spawner somewhere around spawn, but I don't know where that is. If I can find out where there is, I'll probably set up another grinder at that, because that'd be great to have. It'd be nice to be able to farm up lots and lots of arrows. Like I said, I'm kind of low on arrows. I was kind of hoping to get a infinity bow, but a level 30 enchant only got me power 3, I think, so, yeah, let's keep trying for that. Anyways, I don't believe I have anything else to show this episode. So yeah, I think that's about it. This should be a bit of a shorter video, and most of the videos going forward should be a little bit shorter. Because the goal of this series right now is just to show off the kinds of things I build. And I'm not going to be doing a lot of building on camera. If I do, I'm going to try and get my camera account on and use that to do some building. I do have a skeleton horse I found. I actually had the skeleton horse ambush thing happen during a rainstorm somewhere over here. But yeah, since I haven't seen any horses, like regular horses on the server, I decided to just go for one of these. Looks like there's some more over there too. But yeah, so going to be keeping videos a bit shorter from here on out, unless there's, you know, specific things I really want to talk about. I'm kind of also gearing this series as kind of like a vlog kind of channel, where I basically talk about like everything going on with, or not a vlog type of channel, a vlog type of video series, where I talk about everything going on with my YouTube channel and like the series that I'm working on and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, I think that's about all I have for this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.